Welcome to the final episode of the Beef Bar Bruin Banter TV for the 2012-13 season. We're here at the Beef, and as you know, the Bruins were eliminated on March 16th in five games against Yorkton, and we thought we'd show you a little highlight package from the second half of the season. Take a look.
Dark and so it all
Welcome to the final episode of the Beef Bar Bruin Banter TV for the 2012-13 season. It's come to this. This is the last one of the year. Episode 26 now. I got to say, I wasn't sure if we'd make it this far, here we are, joined by Bruins head coach and GM Keith Cassidy. Keith, it's the last one.
It's been an amazing run, hasn't it? I mean, who knew they'd pick up the option after the first four or five of them? But here we are, and yeah, 26, that's pretty good.
Kind of thought we'd get canceled after four or five, but we made it.
You can't keep good personality down.
Apparently not. All right, so final episode of the year. This is going to be just more of a fun kind of a laid-back kind of thing. I know you were curious about my fantasy sports goings-on this week.
Definitely need an update. We haven't had one in the last little while. I haven't seen the Bushman's picks of the week out. We need to see that this week. So go ahead and roll out who you think's going to be a producer this week.
Bushman's Fantasy League.
Are we talking fantasy hockey or March Madness?
We can go either way. You know, give us a little bit of each.
Okay. Fantasy hockey. You'll be happy to know I'm winning 8-2 in one of my matchups. I'm pretty thrilled about that. I'm sure you know everybody out there watching this is too. And tied 5-5 in the other one. So we'll see how that one turns out.
And we were talking about your obviously your March Madness bracket, and you said they had a very scientific way of filling it out. Do you want to elaborate on that? Or?
Well, basically I looked at the bracket. For each matchup, I took about, you know, one, maybe 1.5 seconds, and then, you know, made a snap decision and went from there. So very scientific.
Yeah, and you've jumped on the wagon of one particular team this year, and you're going to ride them all the way?
Georgetown, number two, going all the way.
You've got them all the way to the finals in your bracket?
All the way to victory in the finals.
Oh, well, congratulations on that. That's good.
Well, we'll wait to see what happens first.
Well, pick one and stick with them.
Anyway, the rest of my final four, you'll be fascinated to know, I'm sure. Gonzaga, I'm trying to remember, Gonzaga, Louisville, and Syracuse. You can tell I put a lot of thought into that, by the way.
Well, Louisville is always a perennial contender, are they not?
Yeah, usually they make a pretty good run.
Okay. And Gonzaga's doing pretty good this year. Got a pretty good Canadian kid on that team.
They do.
So it'll be interesting to see how that goes. There's quite a few Canadians in the March Madness this year, so it'll be fun to watch.
Yeah. So you know this, but yet you never filled out a bracket?
No, I did not fill out a bracket. We don't have an office pool going over at Spectra right now, so... No, I didn't fill one out. It used to be a big thing back when I was playing that guys would all get together and fill out a bracket, but I guess my process was about as technical as yours. Go through and basically flip a coin and see how you do. And there was actually one year I ended up winning the whole thing. None of my guys were in the final four, but I had more teams progress.
Let's go back to hockey for a minute. Your Jets are actually doing quite well lately. What are your thoughts on them?
Lost the other day. I know Chad Saxon will be happy about that, but it was a heck of a game, and you can't deny the crowd participation, and that was phenomenal. And I don't know. I talked to a couple of my buddies that were at the game, and you know, if you're watching it on TV, I don't think you can fully appreciate the kind of impact that the crowd actually has on those games. And I think it came through the other night, and you know, hey, first place in the Southeast is nothing to that's pretty good right now. I mean, I know it's the Southeast, but hey, first place is first place, right?
You beat me to the punch on that, the Southeast, as I like to call it, but it's better than second or third in the Southeast.
Well, didn't they beat the Leafs two in a row?
Maybe.
I'm pretty sure they did. You know, that helped them catapult over whoever they were chasing and right into first place. So I'd like to thank the Leafs for that.
Well, the Leafs just beat Tampa, so they helped you out a little bit more there, I think.
Well, it's nice to see them get back on the right track, I guess. I kind of got to be a little bit sympathetic. You're a long-suffering Leafs fan, so, got a little bit more respect for them now. They have Randy Carlyle behind the bench, so we'll see how that goes. But, yeah, happy with the Jets, and as long as they beat the Leafs every time they see him, I'm happy.
I don't know if I would count on that happening much longer.
I don't think they'll face them the rest of the year, do they?
I really have no idea. You're kind of testing my memory here.
You're supposed to be up on all these things. You're supposed to be the one asking the questions and being thoroughly knowledgeable of that stuff. So, but I don't know if they play them again the rest of the year, but you know, it'll be an exciting stretch run. There's some people making noise that nobody thought would. So that always makes for an exciting, you know, the fact that it's a shortened season wasn't a great thing, but it's exciting to see all the players that are in the mix right now.
All right, well, that's going to wrap it up for the first season of the Beef Bar Brew and Banner TV. We'll see if we got renewed for season two, but I just want to thank everybody for watching this year. You know, this was something that myself and Reese, our cameraman, just kind of, you know, tossed around over the summer, and it worked out pretty well. You know, it's been a fun thing for us to do, and hopefully everybody watching has enjoyed it. And also want to thank the Beef. We're at the Beef right now. Just want to thank them also for sponsoring us this year, and that was a great help too. So any final thoughts?
No, I guess just thanks for everybody for watching all year long, and you know, best of luck to cameraman Reese here in his new endeavors. I don't know if Beef Bar Brew and Banter TV is going to be the same without him.
Yeah, we're going to have to go looking for a replacement producer and cameraman. That's not going to be fun.
Well, it's the big shoes to fill, that's for sure.
Definitely. All right, thanks for watching, everybody.